We were over at the Bellagio, and my wife was on a roll at the video poker machines. And so it was a Friday night, and so I said, give me $100. And so we're playing with house money right now. So I go over to the Bellagio, and I go to that great restaurant that overlooks the fountains. And I walk up, and the maitre d' says, do you have a reservation? And I said, yes, it's the Franklin party. And he slides it back to me and says, it'll need to be a party of 10. A lot of managers get trapped in that issue of reams after reams of printouts and paper and numbers. I worked with a guy who was the head of logistics for Schwarzkopf in Desert Storm. He became the head of logistics for Sears in Chicago. And this guy, I got to hear him speak, an amazing speaker, an amazing leader. And he basically, if you want to come to him and talk about an issue or talk about a challenge, you have to put whatever information you want him to consider on a 3x5 file card, because that's all he's going to read. So many times we get into paralysis by analysis. Leaders do not allow that to happen. That's that data trap down there at the bottom. Leaders don't get stranded down there. That's where managers play. Leaders are up at the wisdom. Let me walk you through a real quick example right here. I love the medical profession for this one. By the way, when we go to our doctors today, it's interesting. I spend 30 minutes with my doctor, of which he spends 15 minutes complaining about regulations in the medical industry. It's really exciting stuff. He's also a huge Alabama fan, so we spend 10 minutes talking about Alabama and the Crimson Tide, and then 5 minutes he wants to know what's going on with me. But in the medical profession, let's say you go in the doctor today, you get home, you go in the doctor, you're not feeling all that good, and you go in and you find out you've got 104 fever. Now, for us, we automatically move up to information because we know the norm, right? To move from data to information, you got to know what the average is. Is this a good number or a bad number? 104, good or bad? Bad number, because we're supposed to be 98.6, but the problem with doctors now is it's not enough anymore. It's not just, we also knew, by the way, cholesterol wasn't supposed to be over 200. Now we got good cholesterol and we got bad cholesterol. My bad cholesterol is too high, my good cholesterol is too low. Then they throw triglycerides in the mix. I think they're worrying us to death more than helping us do anything else. So if you've got 104, you know 98.6 is normal. By the way, Hannibal Lecter fans, the brain starts to cook in its own juices about 107. So what are you looking for the doctor to do after you find out that you're sick and you're hot? What do you want the doc to do? Fix it. And that's what intelligence is. Give me options in terms of how I can fix this thing. Well, George, we can put you on IVs, we can give you a shot, we can give you a prescription. I could, by the way, when I had pneumonia one time, the doc said, well, you're going to go off the road for 2 weeks, or I'm going to put you in the hospital for 5 days. At which point I showed him my calendar and said, doc, I got to be in Toronto, I got to be in Boston. He looked at me and he said, so I assume you're going for the hospital option. Okay, so we're looking for the doctor to give us choice, and you're team members are looking for you, the leader, to come up with some alternatives and with their help come up with those alternatives. But the true leaders move all the way up to wisdom. And wisdom is where you can provide the advice in terms of, all right, you want to go this direction with your career. All right, you want to go this direction on your project. Here's the upside. Here's the downside of doing that. The choice at the end of the day, most of the time, has to be theirs. But we want them making informed decisions, not uninformed decisions, and we're not going to allow ourselves to get trapped down there in data. People say they're in information overload today. I don't think they are. I think they're in data overload.